came back 5 days a week. So now here it is in our next year, and we're in fifth grade, and we're able to rehearse 2 days a week. The Martin Kellogg kids rehearse on Mondays and Wednesdays, and the John Wallace kids rehearse on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And we were able to even have a field trip to do one rehearsal together. So that was really exciting. We did that yesterday morning. All right, so without any further ado, I am going to invite a couple of student narrators to come up and introduce our pieces and tell you a little bit about what we are learning in orchestra this year.
My name is Haley, and I'm a student at Martin Kellogg Middle School. We would like to welcome you to our winter concert. Before we begin, please take a moment to silence your electronic devices, including your cell phones. Our performers have worked hard, and we don't want them to get distracted. Also, please take a moment to notice the closest exit in case of an emergency.
My name is Maddie Tiffany, and I'm a student at Martin Kellogg Middle School. This is our fifth grade orchestra. Our first song is called Majestic March. It was composed in 2006 by Paul Lavender. All of the instrument sections in our orchestra have a turn to play the melody. Sometimes we will play in unison, but we also have independent parts. We hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Before I have our next student greeter come on up and greet, I would just like to publicly thank Riley, who is our last minute cello player today. Riley is a sixth grade student at John Wallace, and we had a couple of students who were sick and couldn't make the performance tonight. So I asked Riley this morning if she could help us out, and she very graciously agreed to. She is basically sight reading the music that the students are playing today, so thank you, Riley.
My name is Sakai, and I'm a student at John Wallace Middle School. Our next piece is called Rustic Dance, and it was composed in 2000 by Mark Williams. Some of our instruments get to play double stops. Double stops happen when the music tells you to play two notes at the same time. We hope you have enjoyed our portion of the concert. When we have finished playing Rustic Dance, there will be a brief pause while the fifth grade orchestra leaves the stage and the sixth grade orchestra gets ready to perform for you.
start asking the sixth grade students who sat in the front row at our rehearsal on Thursday, to or on Friday rather, to please come get their instruments. They will be either with you or right over here. Okay, in this area over here. Come get your instruments, come get yourself set up, please. Sixth grade students who sat in the second row at our rehearsal on Friday, please get your instruments, get yourself set up, and start unpacking, and double check tuning if you want to, and we'll get started in a couple of minutes. Thank you.
Lauren. I'm a student at John Wallace. This is our sixth grade orchestra. Most of our orchestra members are third year players. In sixth grade, we are starting to learn how to tune our own instruments using our fine tuners. We also begin studying new time signatures such as 3/4 time, as well as moving away from the key of D major to start playing in other keys.
My name is Siri. I am a student at John Wallace Middle School. Our first piece is called Aeroplane. It was written in 2012 by Michael Hopkins. It was first written to describe a flight and has sections with titles that include Leaving the Gate, In the Air, Snack Time, Turbulence, Cruising Altitude, Descendant, and Landing. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Our next piece is called Duckweed. My name is Finn, and I am a student at John Wallace Middle School. Our next piece is called Dominique's Dance, and it was composed in 2008 by John Nito. It is in the key of G major. In the program notes for Dominique's Dance is about a father who is holding his newborn baby girl and is picturing her quinceañera in his imagination. The father is thinking ahead to the time he will dance a waltz with his daughter at the celebration. Dominique's Dance is in the style of the waltz and is in a new time signature for us called 3/4 meter. All of the instruments get to take turns playing with the melody. We hope you enjoy this piece.
These next two pieces are listed in the programs as interlude music. And that's because I kind of left it up to the students themselves whether they wanted to perform tonight and told them that they had right up until now to say, I don't want to do it tonight. I don't want to do it tonight. Because the next part that we're going to share with you is the regional auditions. Connecticut Music Educators Association sponsors a festival every year. And students are invited to prepare scales and a solo piece that they then perform for judges This year it was virtual, so they did a recording and that got sent into the judges for them to listen to. And if they're successful with all of that, they get accepted into this festival. So we have two students from our sixth grade orchestra who were brave this year and decided to audition, Jacob on violin and Riley on cello, and they are both going to perform their solo pieces for you. So first we're gonna have Jacob do his piece, which is called the Gavotte in D major. And Riley's piece is called Jig.
Thank you. And I'd just like to mention that both of these students are going to be representing our middle schools at the Elementary Honors Orchestra Festival, which will be performing in Hartford on March 31st, so later next month. Thank you both, and congratulations on preparing such challenging music for us tonight, and for sharing that with us. All right.
My name is Alexandra, and I'm a student at John Waltz. The other few fifth graders have passed all of their playing assessments early, and were invited to join our sixth grade orchestra for our next piece. These fifth grade students mostly practice this piece on their own with some coaching of Ms. Palazonis. They joined the sixth grade orchestra for rehearsal. We're going to invite those students to join us on stage now.
My name is Shai. I am a student at John Wallace. Our last piece is called Medieval Kings, and it was composed in 2010 by Suni Newbold. It is in the key of E minor. All the instruments in our orchestra get a chance to play the melody. Thank you for coming to our concert. We hope you will be able to join us for our spring orchestra concert on May 19th at John Wallace Middle School. Have a good night.
Thank you.
We hope you can join us on May 19th at John Wallace for our spring concert. Thank you again, everybody.
Thank you.
Good evening again, everybody. For those of you that I haven't met before, my name is Mary Paula Zonis, and I am the orchestra director at both Morton Kellogg and John Wallace Middle Schools. I'd like to welcome you to our first public performance in a little over 2 years. According to my notes, the last concert we had, orchestra concert live, was back on January 28th, 2020. So it was just a little bit over 2 years ago. So this is our 7th and 8th grade orchestra, and we have been working very hard. We're so glad that we're back live 5 days a week at the start of the year this year, that we're able to rehearse 2 days a week together. We're very thankful we were able to have a field trip so that we could practice both orchestras together one time before we had our concert for you this evening. So I am going to turn this over now to our students and let them tell you a little bit about what we're learning and introduce some of our pieces.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Suri Sanchez, and I am a student at Martin Kellogg Middle School. We would like to welcome you to our winter concert. Before we begin, please take a moment to silence your electronic devices, including your cell phones. Our performers have worked hard, and we don't want them to get distracted. Also, please take a moment to notice the closest exit in case of an emergency.
My name is Paige, and I am a student at our 7th and 8th grade orchestra. Our 7th and 8th grade orchestra have worked hard this year in many different areas. We have been working on learning to read and perform quite a variety of music styles. We are learning more about tuning our instruments and about moving our tuning pegs. We are also learning about shifting to new positions on our instruments, which allow us not only to play higher notes, but also to make some fingering patterns.
Hi, my name is Alexandra Okamura, and I'm a student at Mariah Kellogg Middle School. We are going to begin our portion of tonight's concert with a piece called Rhythm and Blues. It was composed by Soonhee Newbold. This arrangement uses new rhythm patterns for us to read and perform. We are joined by some 6th grade students who have passed their playing assessments early and challenged up to play this piece with us.
Sixth graders, would you wave a bow or wave your hand so that your parents and the audience members can find you? There are quite a few of them who challenged up. I'm very, very proud of them. And I'd also like to mention at this performance that we have the Connecticut Music Educators Association regional auditions for Northern Region Orchestra, and Riley, who plays cello, and Jacob, who plays violin, they both auditioned for the festival. And I wanted to share with everybody that they have both been selected for a different ensemble called the Northern Region Elementary Honors Orchestra. That's open to 5th and 6th graders. So they will be representing John Wallace and Martin Kellogg on March 31st at a convention in Hartford. So we're looking forward to that. So. So without further ado, we're going to do our version of Rhythm and Blues. We hope you enjoy it.
My name is Cecilia Malinowski, and I'm a student at Martin Kellogg Middle School. Our next piece is called Festive Dance. It was written by Colin Stroman. It's in the form of polka, and it uses a lot of repeats. We hope you enjoy it.
So before we formally close our winter concert, I'd like to thank you all again for supporting our orchestra program and supporting our music program in general at both schools. It's really nice to be back in person again, isn't it? And I really wanted to thank all of you for working so hard and for sticking with it all of this time. Because I know it's not easy to practice in your room by yourself when we were shut down. And now we're back together, and you all did such a nice job tonight. I'm very proud of everybody, sixth graders and fifth graders as well, from the earlier performance this evening. So thank you, too, for being so willing to try new styles of music. You know, it's not that typical that orchestras play in jazz or blues styles. And the next piece that we're going to play is maybe a little more what we would consider standard repertoire, but something that really surprised and pleased me is that 7th and 8th graders seem to enjoy playing this next piece, which is from an opera. Who knew they'd like opera? But they do seem to enjoy this piece. So without further ado, I'm going to turn it back over to our student announcers, and they're going to come up and introduce our last piece. So thank you again very much, everybody, and high school helpers, too, who came back to help, and our crowd in the back, Mr. Tobridge and his lighting and sound crew and live streaming for us so that we could have a safe concert with an appropriate size audience. So thank you to everybody.
My name is Luke Bacalco. I am a student at John Wallace Middle School. Our last piece is called March of the Meistersingers, and it is from an opera called Der Meistersinger von Nürnberg. The opera was composed in 1868 by the German composer Richard Wagner. At over 4 hours long, this is the longest opera that is regularly performed.
Hi, my name is Kai Riley, and I'm a student at John Wallace Middle School. Thank you for coming to our concert, and we hope you will be able to join us for our spring orchestra concert on May 19th at John Wallace Middle School. Have a great night.